वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द वीडियो लेक्चर इन सिग्नल एंड सिस्टम्स। वी आर स्टडिंग फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर्स वी हैव कवर्ड हाउ टू डिटरमाइन द इंटीग्रल ट्रांसफॉर्म दैट इज़ कॉल्ड एज फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म फॉर द नॉन पीरियोडिक सिग्नल। देन वी हैव कवर्ड द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ ड्यूअलिटी। ऑल्सो we have seen Fourier transform for special functions. Okay, now for today we are going to study the important Fourier transform pairs that are used. So starting with the Fourier transform, if we have a signal xt we have a signal xt, then the Fourier transform for this signal can be represented as x omega. Okay, so if we want to determine the Fourier transform for first Fourier transform pair, that is delta t. Okay, so we have calculated Fourier transform for delta t, that is 1 in the previous lecture. Second, if you wanted to calculate the Fourier transform for delta t minus t naught, okay, so this is a time shifting property and it is similar that we have covered in Laplace transform. So it is equal to 1 multiplied by e to the power minus j omega t naught. Okay, third, if you multiply delta t by a, so the Fourier transform will be A. Okay, fourth, if you are having A multiplied by delta T plus T naught, then the Fourier transform will be A multiplied by e to the power j omega T naught. Okay, so if the time shifting delta t minus t naught, then it will be e to the power minus j omega t naught, and if the signal is delta t plus t naught, then it is e to the power j omega t naught. So these are the Fourier transform pairs related to the signal delta t. Okay, now if we have our signal as 1, then using duality we can calculate the Fourier transform, that is equal to 2 pi delta omega. We have covered this thing using duality. Okay, so if it is 1 is multiplied by a naught, then the Fourier transform will be multiplied by a naught. Okay, so it will be 2 pi a naught delta omega. Okay, now we have seen one of the important property also, that is called as frequency shifting. So if we have a naught multiplied by e to the power minus j omega naught t, then the Fourier transform will be 2 pi a naught and delta. If there is minus, then we have plus omega plus omega naught, okay, and if we have plus, then it will be minus. So it will be omega plus omega naught, and if we have either plus, then we have minus here. So it will be 2 pi a naught delta omega minus omega naught. Then we have covered ut. If the signal is ut, so it will be a impulse train, a periodic impulse train from minus infinity to some time t. So the Fourier transform will be 1 by j omega plus pi del omega, which we have covered in our previous lecture. Okay, so these are the Fourier transform related to ut and 1. So if you see, if we have a signal as e to the power minus at or e to the power plus at, then we have calculated the Fourier transform also. So if we have a signal e to the power minus at, then the Fourier transform will be 1 divided by a plus j omega. Okay, if we have signal as e to the power plus at, then the Fourier transform will be 1 divided by a minus j omega, which we have covered. After that हमने देखा था कि when we have a signal e to the power minus a mod t, okay, so for this signal also we have covered Fourier transform. तो Fourier transform क्या होगा, 2a divided by a square plus omega square. Okay, so this is very important and you have to remember it. After that, if we have a signal t e to the power minus at, okay, so for this signal the Fourier transform will be written. How the Fourier transform will be written, let us see quickly. It will be equal, if t is multiplied by e to the power minus at, then the property we called as, so this property is called as frequency differentiation. Okay, the frequency differentiation, so let us quickly see how we can calculate the Fourier transform using the property of frequency differentiation. If we have t to the power n x t, then the Fourier transform will be written as, so for this signal the Fourier transform will be written as j to the power n, okay, and d divided by d omega n. So this is a differentiation of x omega. So whatever will be the Fourier transform for this signal xt, that is x omega, yahan pe uska differentiation hoga up to n times according to the value of t, and j to the power n se hum usse multiply karna hoga. Okay, so likewise if we are having the signal as t e to the power minus at. Here, using this property, we will cover if the signal is t e to the power minus at, then this is our x t. E to the power minus at is our this portion is called as x t according to our formula of frequency differentiation. Then t to the power 1 is written here. Okay, so the Fourier transform can be written as j to the power 1 equal to j to the power 1 d by d omega as n is equal to 1. In bracket we are having 1 divided by a plus j omega. Okay, so if I differentiate the part and simplify, then it will be equal to j d by d omega of a plus j omega. First part will be equal to 0, and in the denominator we have a plus j omega square minus 1 multiplied by d omega of a plus j omega, that is equal to j. Okay, so j is equal to under root of minus 1, that is iota. So minus minus multiply and we get the answer as 1 divided by a plus j omega square. So this is the Fourier transform pair using the property of frequency differentiation. Now we have covered for a special function. So special functions, like we have rectangular pulse, that is a rectangular t by t naught. So for this signal the Fourier transform can be written as at divided by at sample omega t divided by 2. Okay, so this is one of the Fourier transform jo ki humne प्रीवियस लेक्चर में कवर किया. इसके बाद वी हैव कवर्ड फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म फॉर कॉस ओमेगा नॉट टी. सो फॉर कॉस ओमेगा नॉट टी द फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म विल बी रिटन. सबसे पहले हमने क्या किया था, इसको एक्सपोनेंशियल कॉस ओमेगा नॉट टी को एक्सपोनेंशियल की टर्म में लिखा था, और उसके बाद हमने डिटरमाइन किया था कि फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म इज इक्वल टू पाए मल्टीप्लाइड बाय डेल्टा ओमेगा माइनस ओमेगा नॉट प्लस डेल्टा ओमेगा प्लस ओमेगा नॉट. ओके, आफ्टर दैट वी हैव कवर्ड साइन ओमेगा नॉट टी. सो द फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म फॉर साइन ओमेगा नॉट टी इज इक्वल टू पाई डिवाइडेड बाय जे मल्टीप्लाइड बाय डेल्टा ओमेगा माइनस ओमेगा नॉट माइनस डेल्टा ओमेगा प्लस ओमेगा नॉट. ओके, सो इन दिस वे वी हैव कवर्ड थ्री स्पेशल फंक्शंस. नाउ इफ वी वांटेड टू डिटरमाइन द फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म फॉर one of the special function called as sgnt. So xt, if we are having xt is equal to sgnt. So if I visualize this function, this is the function. SGNT can be written as so हम SGNT को उसके mathematical format में लिखने के लिए सबसे पहले visualize करना चाहते हैं signal को. SGNT is a signal that is having a value positive 1 when t is greater than 0 and negative 1 when t is less than 0. Okay, so we can write from here that the signal SGNT can be written as SGNT signal can be written as 2 ut minus 1. Okay, so this is how the SGNT can be written. So for UT, we have seen the Fourier transform is equal to 1 by J omega plus pi delta omega. Okay, if I multiplied this whole term by 2, I'm calculating the Fourier transform. So this is a time domain signal, and this is a in time domain, and this is in frequency domain. Okay, plus for 1 we have calculated Fourier transform for 1, that is equal to 2 pi delta omega, and further simplifying we will get, sorry, this is a minus sign here. Okay, so we are having 2 divided by J omega plus 2 pi del omega minus 2 pi del omega. So 2 pi del omega and 2 pi del omega will cancel out, and we will finally have 2 divided by J omega. So this is our answer for SGNT. Okay, so we have seen the Fourier transform for SGNT here. Now if we wanted to calculate the Fourier transform for A plus SGNT, okay, so for A plus SGNT, the Fourier transform will be, for A, you have seen the Fourier transform for A will be like 2 pi A delta omega, and plus for SGNT it is equal to 2 divided by J omega. Okay, so finally we have covered the Fourier transform pairs, almost all Fourier transform pairs that are very important for examination purpose. So I wanted you to learn the Fourier transform pairs, what are the formula for different Fourier transform pairs. So if we are having any type of signal xt, then we are able to determine the Fourier transform for our signal, that is x omega. So this is all for today, and I hope you will enjoy this video, and thank you very much.